I want to say just a few words about North Carolina, my home state, possibly the finest state in this entire union. We got industry of all kinds, pretty country, raise corn, cotton, tobacco, peaches, peanuts, all like that. Got colleges all over the state, fine quality, pretty girls, and run off the finest white lightning made anywhere. Hey, I see you all ain't forgot your raisin. But it is. This government stuff that you all use up here in New York and all, that'll kill you. It will. You can't tell what's in it. Here last New Year's Eve, I was up in New York, and I got betrayed into drinking several folks' health. And I was trying to be as robust as I could about it. And I kept on drinking their healths, friends, till I'll tell you the truth, my own pretty near become endangered. But, well, now that's not true about white lightning. Now you can tell what's in that because you can see through it. And I never shall forget my first swallow of it. I took a good one, and I swallowed her down, and she hit bottom. And my face turned red, my eyes rolled back, and I gagged just a little bit. And then by and by, I got over it. And some of the boys says, "How are you?" And I says, "Boys, I'm doing fine, gaining ground all the time. And I think I've got her if she don't jump." "Yes, sir," I says. Says, "Give me just a minute to rest, and I'll try her again." There was one fella that lived there close to me there a while, a fella named Sam Wood. And he made the best they was made anywhere around. But he had bad luck with it. He seemed like every time he'd run off a batch, why, he'd get caught. And he was on the county roads so long and got so old that they finally just put him to a cooking. And he was serving up the boys one night. He was serving up a mess of creasy salad. That's turnip greens. It's not really. I just don't know what else to call them. But he was serving them up, and one of them called him back. Says, "Sam," says, "come in." Says, "There's a lizard in my greens." Sam looked back and forth and says, "Hush." Says, "The others will want one too." Be good, fixed right. Sam, he had bad trouble with drinking a whole lot of it, too. But he quit about, five, six, 7 years ago. And I got to talking about it with him one time. I says, "Sam, did you ever have the DTs? He says, "Boy, I had them when they first come out." Now, I'd like to report to you here that there is excellent progress going on all over. Down there, even in the most backwoods communities at home, they're getting all kinds of modern conveniences. There was a fella that worked at the same factory that I used to with my daddy there in Mount Airy, and he come in out of the mountains one morning just as mad as he could be. And he says, "Carl," says, "the people up there in the mountains getting to act just like the people in town." Says, "There's a family of them up there close to us that started putting screens on their windows, shutting the flies out on everybody else." And, well, then too, I think this is pretty good. Nearly all of our local officials can read and write now. They can. And some of them do their own punctuating. There was one in particular that I remember. He was learning pretty good. And he is down at the barber shop reading the paper, showing off. Well, he is reading along, and he says, "I see him while so-and-so paid the spring sacrifice." And the barber says, "Yeah, I heard where he is killed." Says, "Don't say he is killed, says he paid the spring sacrifice." It's not very funny, I just thought I'd tell you. And we are thrifty. I'm proud of that. I had an uncle one time. He said he bought him a new pair of shoes off a fella. Said he paid $3.25 for them. Pretty brown shoes. And said he put them on, and he was walking on uptown. And said he was walking along, and said his left shoe commenced to hurt him a little. And he was limping just a little bit, and said he was walking on, and he passed one of his friends. Says, what are you limping for? He says, I bought these shoes and this left is hurting me just a little. He says, why don't you cut them? He says, I ain't gonna cut these shoes. Says, I paid $3.25 for them. Kept on walking, there's a hurting worse, and he got studying about that thing. And he got studying, maybe that fella had something about cutting that shoe. He says, I took my knife, and I cut a little hole just about that size right where the sore was. And he says, you know, I wouldn't took $3.25 for that hole. Well, he told me that, and I had to get up off the porch. But now, them of you that has to live here in Washington, there's a whole lot to be admired about Washington, too. Cherry trees, monuments, and everything like that. The main thing, though, that I admire about Washington are the pretty girls. And I'm bound to say that. They are as pretty and well-built as any I ever seen tried to fill a balloon dress. And I love to look at them. My wife told me a long time ago, she says, you can look at the pretty girls, but don't you never touch them. And friends, I've tried to live by that. Of course, that throws me to do an extra lot of looking just to make up for that one handicap. Well, I reckon we might as well go right ahead and get right on into the service. Is the choir ready? All right. Tempestuous one, I am your slave. For behold, I love you all. Your eyes, your hair, your hands, your ears, your tooth, your everything. Come, fly away with me. Let us sing, let us dance, let us play at youthful games and fill the night air with youthful laughter ere the spring cometh. Hey, nonny, nonny. I am weak, I faint, I fail. For verily I am as a drooping daffodil. I cry your mercy, pity, love. Give me all. It is too much. Thy kiss, nay, it is more than a kiss. It is a bite at my heart. Ah, beloved, how can I tell you of my love? Hark! Hear my heart. Here it stands neath the jasmine branches, waiting in despair. Oh, the rapture, if thou would but gaze on it. Alas, oh, unreturned love, 'tis done. Prithee, my beloved, kiss me ere I perish.
Come true. that wandering is over, and train whistles back up no more. I'll return to my love in the valley and the little brown church evermore.
Damn, I didn't know Andy Griffith could sing like that.